scenario. You are not at home, you are somewhere with no Wi-Fi, or maybe crappy Wi-Fi, or you don't have the Wi-Fi password, and you have your Mac with you, and you need to get on the internet with your Mac. Now, if you have your iPhone, and you have a data plan with your phone, and you don't mind using some of that data, you can actually connect your Mac to the internet through your phone. Basically, your phone creates a wireless network that your Mac can join. Now, I'm going to show you how to do this. It's amazing. It's called Personal Hotspot. Now, I've personally found that this works in the first attempt about 75% of the time. I'll start by showing the quick way and how it's supposed to work. You want to start on your Mac with your iPhone nearby and just go into your Wi-Fi menu up here in the top right. And you'll see your iPhone name will either appear up at the top of the list or somewhere alphabetically, and mine shows up here. You just click to join it and then wait a couple seconds. And then if you look down at your phone, you'll pretty quickly see a blue bar show up across the top. Now this means that it worked and that you are connected. On your Mac, you're going to see in the Wi-Fi menu these two little interlinked circles here. Now I am online on my Mac and I can watch that super urgent cat video in full screen. Warning, may cause excessive use of your cell phone data plan and your iPhone battery. May cause you to go over your monthly data allowance with your cell phone provider. May cause your hand to feel overly warm when you touch your iPhone. Please use with caution, keep your phone charged, and watch your data usage. Now in terms of what to do if it doesn't work immediately, you want to grab your iPhone and go into your control center. Notice that you have Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and personal hotspot icons here in the top left. All three of these need to be on and happy in order for this to work easily and for it to work wirelessly. One by one, and with a little pause in between, we want to turn off Wi-Fi, turn off Bluetooth, and then turn off personal hotspot, and then just wait a couple seconds, and then turn on Wi-Fi, turn on Bluetooth, and turn on personal hotspot. Once you've turned those guys off and then on again, just go back to your Mac under the Wi-Fi menu and see if it works now to click and join it. Now it might ask for a Wi-Fi password, which you can see and change on your iPhone if you go to Settings. And then you go to Personal Hotspot, and then you can tap on the password here and change it to whatever you want it to be, and then hit Done. And that means that any computer that joins this Personal Hotspot network is going to need to type in that new password. For me, if it still doesn't work right away, I will usually try rebooting both my iPhone and my Mac. And as a last resort, I'll just reach into my bag and grab the USB lightning cable that connects my Mac directly to my iPhone. And then I actually turn off Wi-Fi on my Mac, plug in that wire directly into my phone until I see that blue thing at the top of the phone, and then I'm online that way through the wire. Bonus of doing it this way is if your phone is connected to your Mac, then your iPhone battery is actually charging while you're using the internet through the phone. Now you can get on the internet wherever you are. Boom, Mac epiphany. If you want someone awesome and totally not condescending to come to you and take all of your technology challenges off your mind, head to macandhome.com because you've got way better things to do with your time.
All right.
Check, one, two, check.
None of that is necessary.